Welcome, dear children. This is part 2 of adverb. In part 1, we had discussed about what an adverb is, and we had also discussed that there are 6 kinds of adverbs, out of which we discussed about adverb of manner and adverb of time with their position in a sentence. Today we'll discuss about adverb of place and adverb of frequency. Let's start our discussion with adverb of place. Adverb of place tells us where or at what place an action took place. So it answers the question where. Now, if you look at the example, they were going out. They were going where? Out. So it is telling us where were they going, and it is also telling what place. So it is adverb of place. The teacher looked for Meena everywhere. The teacher looked for Meena where? Everywhere. What place? Everywhere. So it is adverb of place. Now with this, I know already, but again the position of adverb of place is new to you, so you need to be more attentive over here. Position of adverb of place, the adverb of place is placed after an object in a sentence. So if a sentence has an object, it will be placed after an object. But again, since we all know not all sentences have object, so in such cases where there is no object in a sentence, we put it after the main verb. Let's look at the examples that we have read a few moments before. That is, they were going out. In this example, we don't have any object. So, we have put out, which is an adverb of place, after the main verb. But in the next sentence, the teacher looked for Meena everywhere. Here, we do have an object, that is Meena. And that is why everywhere, which is an adverb of place, is placed after the object. So, if there's an object, it is placed after the object. But if there's no object, then it is placed after the main verb. Now there's something else and something more to know about adverb of place. There are certain words which are used both as an adverb of place and prepositions. For example, out, outside, down, up, etc. All these words, if you have seen or if you have noticed, we use it as preposition as well as adverb of place. Now the question arises that how to differentiate or how to identify whether a particular word is an adverb of place or a preposition. It is very simple. If there is a noun after these words, then it is a preposition. But if there is no noun after it, then it is adverb of place. Now, let's go back to the same examples. They were going out. Here, after out, we don't have any noun. Hence, out is adverb of preposition. Sorry, adverb of place. But if I have to make it preposition, I can write it as they were going out. Example again. The teacher looked for Meena everywhere. So, here everywhere is adverb of place because there is no noun after it. But if I change the position, if I write as teacher looked everywhere for Meena, here if you see Meena is coming after everywhere, that is a noun. So it becomes preposition. Hence the position of adverb of place is very important, because if you change the position and there's a noun after it, it doesn't remain adverb of place and it changes to a preposition. So, there's one more example given here. She walked down the stairs. So, here down is preposition because we have a noun after it, that is the stairs. But the same down I can use an adverb of place, maybe with this sentence, pull your socks down. So, here when you say pull your socks down, down after down, we don't have any noun. Hence, down over here is adverb of place. The next kind of adverb is adverb of frequency. Now, adverb of frequency generally tells us how often a particular action takes place. That means the action doesn't take place only once. Or how many a times, when you can count how many a times a particular action takes place, then it is adverb of frequency and it answers the question how often or how many a times. For example, if I say I visit my grandmother daily, so here daily is adverb of frequency I daily visit my grandmother. Sorry. So here daily is adverb of frequency because it is telling me how many times do I visit my grandmother daily, or how often do I visit my grandmother daily. So children, don't get confused between adverb of frequency and adverb of time, because adverb of time tells about a particular time, but adverb of frequency is more about the repetition of an action. So it tells how many a times or how often, and adverb of time tells us when, that means a particular time. Now again, people get confused with the word once, since once is something that indicates that an action has taken place once. So you will say that miss, once should be adverb of time because the action is taking place only one time. But again, no, this is adverb of frequency. Why? I will help you with an example. If I say I had once met him. So here if I ask the question, when did I meet him? Once. No, it is not answering the question when. It is answering the question how many times did I meet him? Once. How often have I met him? Once. So in this example, if you notice, once answers the question how many a times, even if the action is taking place only one time. But again, it is answering the question how many a times or how often. So that is why it is adverb of frequency and not adverb of time. Again, the position of adverb of frequency. The adverb of frequency is placed before a main verb. And if there is a helping verb, then it is placed between the helping verb and the main verb. So technically, if you see, it is placed before the main verb only. Let's look at it with the help of an example. Rita often helps her mother in the garden. Here helps is our main verb and often is coming before help. So position of adverb of frequency is before the main verb. In the next example, it is Sneha is occasionally late for college. So late is our main verb, is our helping verb, occasionally is coming between the helping verb and the main verb. And technically, if you see, occasionally is coming before the late, that is the main verb. So there shouldn't be any confusion as such. But again, sometimes if you want to put more emphasis on the frequency rather than the action, then you use adverb of frequency at the beginning of the sentence. For example, often I have shopped in these malls. Here the emphasis is not on shopping. The emphasis is on how often have I shopped in these malls. Often. So that is why often is placed at the beginning of the sentence. So when it is placed at the beginning of the sentence, that is for the sole purpose of putting more stress and laying more emphasis on it. This brings us to the end of part 2. In the next part, we'll discuss about adverb of degree and interrogative adverb. Also, we'll discuss about adverb as modifiers. So, yeah, thank you. Take care.